The original Game Boy line dominated the handheld video game scene just shy of 12 amazing years.
In the US, we had three different models to choose.
Man, I just can't do it.
Okay, do I need to start locking my door?
Dude, these Game Boys are practically the same. I can't decide which one I should play.
Practically the same? There are huge differences between them.
Ah, you're just saying that. Oh, look at me! I'm a gamer who's trapped by nostalgia and I love it! Nostalgia, nostalgia, nostalgia!
Enough! Do you want me to give you a breakdown of the differences between all three of these models, or not?
I mean, if you were going to anyway.
Here we go with part two of the Game Boy Hardware Retrospective. If you haven't seen part one yet, go ahead and watch that first to get a surface level understanding of what makes each model unique. This time, we'll be going hands on, so get ready for a deep dive into each model. While each one may seem far too similar to really tell those differences at first glance, under the microscope, they become plain to see. The original Game Boy is equipped with a 160 by 144 resolution screen that uses shades of green to display graphics. To the left of the screen is a red LED marked battery that fades as your battery power runs out. The NES-style buttons really feel like a full-size controller, and both the A and B buttons as well as the Start and Select buttons are slanted to make the layout more ergonomic. The mono speaker in the bottom right can get quite loud, like your mom constantly asks you to turn that game down while on a road trip loud. Over on the left, we have a DC input for external power and a contrast wheel to help you adjust the screen to different lighting conditions. Around the back, we find the cartridge slot that looks well protected. The battery cover, which hides the four AA's used to power the device, has a tab that is a bit on the weak side, and I, along with my friends, all managed to break this tab easily, leaving the battery cover to flop around as you play. On the right is a communication port, or EXT connector if you want to be technical, and the volume wheel below it is pretty beefy, I must say. Up on top, we've got our power switch on the left. Down below, we have a headphone jack. Even with advancements in ergonomics for electronics over the years, this is still a very comfortable handheld device to hold. I can't recall ever having problems holding this when I was a kid, either cramping or trouble with reaching buttons, and it still is comfy in the hand now that I'm an adult. The follow-up model, the Game Boy Pocket, uses a screen that shares the same resolution of the original, but with welcome changes of it being slightly larger, sharper, and using grayscale instead of green shades, you can't help but label it a huge improvement. This model does not have a battery LED indicator, but later versions of the Pocket added it back. The buttons have been shrunk down slightly to account for the smaller form factor, and the Start and Select buttons are now straight instead of at an angle. The speaker isn't as loud as the original, but still gets the job done. Here on the left, both the volume control and communication port have relocated here, replacing the power input and contrast control. The communication port is now smaller, meaning you'll need a special cable or adapter to use multiplayer with the original Game Boy. The back still sports the cartridge slot, although it leaves the game cartridge more exposed this time around, and the battery cover tab feels sturdier. Two AAA's instead of four AA's? What a deal! We see that the contrast control has switched to the right side, which is why I am in a constant state of confusion when I play one of these Game Boys. I never know which wheel does what. The top still contains the power switch, and the bottom still has the headphone jack, and is now the new home of the power input, which is smaller and requires a different cable than the original. The smaller form factor may be uncomfortable for larger hands, as well as the smaller buttons, but the screen is such an improvement. Also, the two AAA batteries makes the Pocket much more energy efficient, even though the speaker does not get as loud. And that brings us to the Game Boy Color. As the name implies, we now have a color screen that even makes older games look better with its sharper pixels and highly reflective screen. It does manage to be the smallest screen of the three models, but that's easy to forgive. We have the battery LED back, and the size of the buttons seem to be identical to the Pocket with the exception of Start and Select. Nintendo can't seem to leave these two buttons alone, can they? Because they're now even smaller. The speaker is also the lowest volume. It really is too soft, even at its loudest volume setting. The left side has a handy new hand strap attachment spot. Oh no, is this where these originated from? And the communication port and volume wheel are the same as the Pocket's. On the back, the cartridge slot looks to be strikingly similar to the Pocket's slot, and the battery cover now has a curve to it for added comfort and an even sturdier tab. The batteries required are now two AA's, so no going into the family's remote controls to steal some batteries. Here on the right now is the power switch, and there is no contrast wheel on the color since it simply isn't needed. On top is a new infrared communication port, which is hardly used outside of Pokemon titles. And on the bottom is the headphone jack and the power input, which again seem identical to the Pocket. The sharp edges have all but disappeared from this model, and it has the most modern feel as a result. The shrunken Start and Select buttons are kind of baffling, but the screen on this model is the best part about it. All Game Boy games look better, and there are 12 different palettes for non-Game Boy Color games to play with.
So, do you understand the differences between the Game Boy, Game Boy Pocket, and Game Boy Color now?
I guess so. 8-bit games are just so hard to get into.
I can understand that. There's quite a bit of imagination that comes into play when going back to these older games.
Yeah, I prefer the modern games, which are much more realistic, like Shovel Knight and Minecraft.
Wait, what? Well, not all opinions are created equal, as they say. I hope you've enjoyed this deep dive into the Game Boy family of systems, and if you've seen my 3DS hardware retrospective... Who am I kidding? Of course you have! You know what to expect next. The finale where we rank the three models we've been studying, and it's going to be a completely non-divisive video which exists on the internet. Actually, sorry, I can't promise that, but I will see you then.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you want to keep on top of the videos, definitely take a sec to subscribe. I'm also on Twitter, Instagram, and Patreon if you want to follow me across the internet. Level 1 Sword also has a weekly podcast, so give it a listen.